Duck, Dog, Dotty. Dotty was born with an incredible nose. She could sniff and sense the tiniest of things that even other dogs couldn't.
Sniff, sniff. Uh-oh, this milk is spoiled. Sniff, sniff. Ooh, a big thunderstorm is coming. Sniff, sniff. Woohoo! A bunch of truffles are in that forest.
Dotty's nose helped make the villagers happy and safe. Her nose helped them ever since she was a little puppy. Now Dotty wanted to help the animals in her village even more. She wanted to save lives. So Dotty went to medical school. Dotty studied very hard. Finally, she graduated and became a doctor. Duck, Dog, Dotty. Duck Dotty used her incredible nose to sniff out problems way, way before they became too late to cure.
Sniff, sniff. Sugar level in the blood is slightly high. Let's cut down on sweets so you won't get diabetes. Sniff, sniff. Blood is not flowing well. Let's exercise more so you won't get a heart attack. Sniff, sniff. There's a tiny polyp in your stomach. Let's remove it so it won't cause trouble.
Last year, Doc Dotty saved her entire village.
Sniff, sniff. You have a new kind of virus. Please stay home until you get better.
Thanks to her quick thinking, none of the other villagers got sick. If she hadn't suggested the quarantine, there would have been a pandemic. One day, Doc Dotty visited a villager named Gow Gow. He was very old and lived by himself. So every week, Dotty paid him a visit.
Hello, Mr. Gow Gow. How are you doing today?
Oh, Doc Dotty. I'm doing well. I've been looking forward to having a nice chat with you,
said Gow Gow.
Doc Dotty wagged her tail.
Okay, let's do a quick checkup first.
She started sniffing Gow Gow as usual. But today, something was odd. She tried to sniff out what it was.
Sniff, sniff. Sugar level is normal. Sniff, sniff. Blood is flowing very well. Sniff, sniff. There's no polyp.
Dotty cocked her head.
What's wrong with Gow Gow?
She thought to herself. Doc Dotty decided not to tell Gow Gow anything until she found out what was going on. She didn't want him to worry.
Doc Dotty, is everything okay?
Gow Gow asked upon seeing Dotty's puzzled face.
Dotty smiled. Oh, nothing. Your vitals smell perfectly normal. Just eat and sleep as well as you've been doing, she said.
Doc Dotty went to see Professor 8 at her medical school.
I don't know what it was, but his head smelled a little bit different, she explained.
Said the professor.
It's hard for me to say what a little bit different is, because I don't have your incredible nose. So, I'm not sure if I can help at this point,
Professor 8 replied. Next week, Doc Dottie visited Gow Gow again. She hoped he smelled okay. Hello, Mr. Gow Gow. How are you doing today? Gow Gow perked up his ears.
Oh, young lady. Nice to meet you. I'm doing well. How can I help you?
Doc Dottie was alarmed. Gow Gow didn't remember her anymore. Doc Dottie met with Professor 8 again and asked how she could cure Gow Gow's forgetfulness. Professor 8 shook his head and said,
I'm so sorry. We don't have any cure for that yet. All you can do is try to keep the patient from getting worse.
Doc Dottie decided to visit Gow Gow more frequently. She wanted to find some clues for a cure. Dottie discovered that Gow Gow would forget recent events, but remembered his past very well. Every time she visited him, he would tell her stories about his wonderful successes from long ago.
When I was just a puppy, I won the annual sumo competition in the village I was born in,
Gow Gow said.
I was the smallest dog among all the contenders, but I was good at the strategy. In the final round, I threw out the champion who was twice my size. When I was young, I worked at the post office, but I wanted to be an architect. So I went to college for architecture. I entered a contest to create the design for the new post office. Guess what? My design won! That is the Plushville Post Office!
Gow Gow also told stories about his family.
My wife was an amazing cook. Her fried noodles were especially fantastic. She added spicy garlic sauce and topped the noodle with a pretty sunny-side-up egg.
Gow Gow looked away.
She had such a beautiful voice. I really miss her singing along with the ukulele. My son is so brave. And he also has a good heart. He wanted to help the villagers, so he became a police dog. Now, he's teamed up with a super smart beagle. I'm so proud of my son, Momo, and his partner, Papa.
Gow Gow looked so happy every time he told his stories. Sometimes he repeated the same story, but Doc Dottie didn't mind. She believed telling stories kept Gow Gow's mind healthy. Also, she really enjoyed Gow Gow's wonderful storytelling. Several months passed. Doc Dottie went to library after library and studied all the research about Gow Gow's memory loss. She couldn't find a cure. Meanwhile, Gow Gow kept forgetting, and he became very sick too. One day, Gow Gow never woke up again. He looked so peaceful. Doc Dottie hung her head and cried. She would miss Gao Gao very much. She would miss his storytelling. His wonderful stories had cured her whenever she felt down. Doc Dottie suddenly realized something. It was not only medicine that cured the villagers. Telling stories could help cure them too, and help them stay healthy. So Doc Dottie began telling her patients fun stories when she met with them. The patients loved her stories and were cheered up. Doc Dottie's stories were inspired by Gao Gao's. She made the stories even more exciting, and the villagers loved it. Do you think this is cheating? No! This is what storytellers do. Look at the villagers' happy faces. Gao Gao became legendary. Mayor Bear inducted Gao Gao into the Hall of Fame in City Hall. Gao Gao the storyteller, thank you for bringing the villagers so much excitement and joy, the plaque read. Doc Dottie kept helping the villagers, not only with her incredible nose, but also with her wonderful storytelling. The villagers would say,
Hey Doc, tell us some more stories.
Well, Dottie began, when Gao Gao was in college.